You guys are fucking on fire out there tonight. I love it. You guys are gonna help us out, right? Go! What thing? I don't know why. Doesn't even matter how hard you try. Keep that in mind. I designed this rhyme to explain in due time. Fly by as the pendulum swings. Watch it count down to the end of the day. The clock ticks life away and it's
so unreal.
Didn't look out below. Watch the time go right out the window. Trying to hold on and didn't even know I wasted it all just to watch you go. I kept everything inside and even though I tried, it all fell apart. What it meant to me will eventually be a memory of a time
I tried so.
So there is a growing mystery. I mean, people around Chester Bennington from Linkin Park, the frontman from Linkin Park, are really confused and say that things just aren't adding up for them, and they're trying to make sense of why Chester made this decision and when he made the decision to take his life. One of the things we've heard statement from the band and that actually matches up with something that we found out about the new house that he had purchased for his family, the home where he actually took his life. He just bought the house just about 2 months ago, just a little under 2 months ago. And it's a beautiful home, and this is not an area where you would typically find a rock star like Chester Bennington living.
Very beautiful neighborhood.
Beautiful neighborhood. It is quiet. It is away from all the action in LA. It
takes a lot to get to anything from there, to be honest with you.
Right. But beautiful home and known for great schools, and he has kids, and maybe that's why he did it. But what they don't understand, the people close to him don't understand, is why make this purchase for your family if...
Yeah, typically when you see people like making long-term plans and thinking long-term, it doesn't really jive with being in the mindset that would lead one to commit suicide.
Right, which is what his bandmates said, and they said that they had been speaking to Chester about their plans for the future, and that he was excited about their plans for the future. So they clearly were looking down the road, and his friends and his family felt like he was looking down the road with his family as well, because he made this purchase. They just moved into the house. He actually The timing of it is also interesting in that they closed on the house on May 26th, mm-hmm. which I believe is 8 days after Chris Cornell killed himself. And we know that Chester was really struggling they were very close friends. So
I mean, of course, guys, people can say, oh, you know what, he was making this purchase, he wanted to set his family up, maybe he knew that this was going to happen. However, you also think if you're going to make some purchase like that, you don't want to, this is a house that he committed suicide in, you don't want that awful memory every time your family walks in the door, which also leads
right.
up to believe that this was a very sudden, very, very
out
of the blue.
I agree with you, Brad. That's the only thing that you can surmise from this. The only clue you can get is this had to be a
rash decision
that he made, and not something that he'd been thinking about for the last couple of months, because everything from his family and from his bandmates makes it seem like Chester was looking forward to the future and
yeah.
then unfortunately made the decision to take his life.
This is a family portrait. This picture is altered. There is someone in this picture that is not in this picture. Che's best friend, Tommy Church, is right here. Don't believe me. You can verify it yourself. If I'm correct, Talinda should have this photo on her social media. And if you zoom in, right here, you'll see that though my hand and my brother Tyler's hand overlap, they do not interact. That is because we aren't holding each other's hand. Church is holding our hands. This photo hangs on the wall of the living room and the house she bought with the money she got in Chester's passing. I could be wrong, but I believe that figure was somewhere around $6 million.
Ha! Chester Bennington's personality, surroundings, finances, and career has been crucial in understanding the motives he may have had to commit suicide. As it turns out, the contrary has been proven. The Linkin Park frontman did not take his own life. He was murdered. Why was Tommy Church removed from the family portrayed by Talinda, as shown by Jamie Bennington, Chester's firstborn son? The lead singer's death certificate, released on July 26, has some strange things. Notice who the informant for this document is? The informant on a California death certificate is the person who provides information about the deceased to the person completing the certificate, typically a funeral director or physician. Tommy acted as the first informant, which tells us that he happened to be on the scene before anybody else. How did he know? Now we know Mike Shinoda was too busy acting as the Uber driver. He couldn't play informant simultaneously. In fact, there is footage of Tommy arriving at the crime scene in luxury private transportation under the plate TCP 1727. A search under that plate number led us to PSG number 11265. Using that number, we got to a carrier called Classic Transportation, headquartered in Palm Springs, California. According to their advertisement, it's a premium chauffeur service, listing big names such as Spotify, Billboard, Disney, and others among its customers. Does this make sense to you? Tommy used premium transportation paid by the record label. But then again, a massive company like Warner Brothers organized a cheap Uber driver to pick up the singer of Linkin Park, one of their main stars. Furthermore, what was Uber even doing there at the time of the emergency call at 8:50 a.m. when the pickup time was 4:30 a.m. to begin with?
Come on, buddy. Yeah, good boy. What's up, American Voodoo Studios, Hollywood? Come on, Iggy. Let's make some tracks.
So this is in the old days, like with the yeah. Like with the occult, like the skull and crossbones thing or whatever, uh-huh. You know? When they would bring you in, they'd bring you in like this, and then they would start talking in their Latin and whatever when you were like getting initiated.
Yeah.
And you'd see red, and all their cloaks are, you know? And then these are the real deal, dude. These are the real fucking deal. Yeah. I had to get like, you know, it took me like a long time to actually get those things here. Those are like the real deal from the olden days. Like those are like from like 1875. Right? So you come into the room and you're blinded, you're not a member yet, and then during your initiation you see through the red, and then once you're done, then you get to like join the orgies and do whatever those fucking people do.
Yes. Oh my god.
Those look great on you, bro. I mean, you could go out in Hollywood like this. You should walk the red carpet like that tonight.
Dude, I should do the carpet with you.
You should.
Testing, Church, Mayor of the World here. 555555. 666666666. Church, Mayor of the World. Church, Mayor of the World.